Assalamu alaikum. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Mukhtar Ahmed with the Virtual University course of Leadership and Team Management. We are here with your lecture number 10. Ladies and gentlemen, we have started the approaches of leadership, the theoretical part, the theories of leadership. And during the 19th century, different researchers, educationists, they try to understand this leadership process. And they try to separate leader from the followers. When they realize that these are very important inputs, are the resources any organization can have, they started them differentiating. They started more and more studies and research to figure out those characteristics, those traits, those attitudes, those behaviors, which can help them to identify a leader and a follower. As we discussed during last lecture, that initially they started with two theories, the trait theory and the behavior theory. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said, that in beginning, they started with two approaches, two theories, the trait theory and the behavior theory. Later on, a third theory was added. A third theory was developed, designed. They call it contingency theories. And during recent time, few more theories are added, few more approaches are identified to understand this process of leadership. Because the focus was to identify those characteristics, those behaviors, those attitudes which can help any organization, any group, any team to pick the right type of leaders. Right? So we started understanding these theories, our approaches of leadership during the last lecture. That was our lecture number 9. I tried to cover two basic approaches. Number one, trait theory. Number two, behavior theory. If you recall, in the trait theory, the basic assumption was leaders are born, not made. And the belief was that leaders are born with some genetical makeup which have specific characteristics which can identify them as leaders. And then they later on, based on different studies, they identify different traits which they thought are the traits which are essential to become a leader, and they are natural. But afterward, they started another approach, and that was the behavior approach. And the assumption was, these are the behaviors which can be learned and which can make a leader, effective leader, another leader, an ineffective leader. And for that purpose, in the behavior approach, or behavior theory, we also discuss couple of studies done by Ohio State and Michigan State University's people. And they figure out that there are two different dimensions of leadership to understand them better. Based on this, then later on, a matrix or managerial grid was designed where two things were plotted: concern with the people and concern with the organizations, our objective or goals. And there were 5 different types of leadership style which was identified there. So both trait and behavior theory try to identify the one best leader or the style of a leader which can be good for everywhere, for every situation. But they were not successful. They couldn't find a single trait or style of a leader which you can take it for granted. This with a person with this particular style of leadership or leader, either trait or behavior, we can say if a person with a specific or X or whatever you'll give it a name, characteristics, a style, a trait, is very successful in one at one situation, on a certain environment, with certain followers, and he or she is going to be again successful when you take it to another situation or when you make him leader of different type of followers. So that was the kind of failure of those approaches, those theory. By the 1960s, it became apparent that there is no such universal answer that you can have for a leader. So what happened then? Then they figure out that the leadership effectiveness depends on certain other things too. And it depends on the leader, the follower, and situation, or situational factors they call it. During the last 5 to 6 decades of time span, you can see, if you review the literature, you can find out dozen and dozen of different theories, these sort of approaches, different studies, which have tried to identify the classification of these approaches, these traits, these behaviors, so that they should identify the leader, or they should understand this leadership process. And most of them, they agree that leadership effectiveness depends on the leaders, the followers, and situation. And of course, when we are talking about the leader, certain traits, certain characteristics, they are playing very important role. Certain behavioral aspects, they are also very important. The same way, the followers, their attitude, their behavior, their cohesiveness, they are also playing very important role. But we are not talking about in isolation. We are talking about them in a situation, reference to a certain situation. Leader in different situation need different kind of characteristics. They have different kind of interests. They might have different kind of value system. They might need different kind of skills to handle. If I'm a leader in a specific organization, I need certain specific type of skills. Similarly, a leader of the bank, a leader of an industry, they both need specific type of skills, specific type of attitude, specific type of behaviors to be an effective leader. And all those three places I just quoted, maybe an education institution, a bank, an industry, or any other institution. See, the followers are different. The leader skill set needed different is different. The style, the value system of all those different organizations, they are different. And yes, situation is also different. So naturally, one leader cannot be effective at all these 3 or 4 places. One person with specific skill sets may not be effective at place B, while he was or she was very effective at place A. Like, I'm a teacher, I have special or specific skill sets which might be making me a good teacher in education institution. And if you take it as a teacher, as a leader, so that I might be a kind of leader. But if you take me and put me in a bank, or maybe place me in an organization, any production unit, I might not exert anything there. Because the specific skill set, the attitude, the value system of that particular organization and situation is different. So these were the bases which kind of trigger different kind of studies, different kind of approaches to the scientists, to the researchers, that they should look about these things. It is not that simple that you cannot say that, okay, A, B, C, these are the 3, 4, 5 traits, and these are the 4 or 5 behaviors which are good for a leader, for a person to become a leader. And then you cannot just certify that this leader is going to be successful everywhere, because there are certain other factors. This is situation is another one, and the followers and leaders, him or herself. So these things kind of push that leadership should be seen in a different way, with a different direction. So the idea and deeds of the leader match the need of the expectation of the followers in a particular situation was understood. It was understood that it depends on the type of followers and the situation and the way leader is functioning or acting there, which is going to create a difference. So like, let's see the Qaid-e-Azam, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, our great leader. We can give his example. He was a leader. He has specific followers. In this particular situation, he was able to exert, and he was able to create this nation for, we call it Pakistan. We can give the example of Nelson Mandela. See, he was under different situation. His followers type was different. The environment he was facing was totally different. People also call Hitler as a leader. So at his time, the situation was totally different. His value system was different. His attitude was different. The situation was different. So during that time period, he might be a leader for his followers. And he was known as leader for Germany at that time. Similarly, if you remember during first, I think it was second or third lecture, I gave you a few examples of the leader. And I gave you example of Mother Teresa. I gave you example of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. See, they are also known to be as a leader, Imran Khan. But see, their followers are different. Their behavior, their attitude, their skill sets, totally different from one another. So that was the point which gave a kind of us direction, which gave us a vision, that we should start looking leaders in a different prospect, in a different way. So that is where this third strategy, third approach, third theory was originated. We call it contingency theory. Again, in contingency theory, different studies were carried out. So based on those studies, different type of approaches were defined. So let me try to explain to you a few ideas, and I will explain only 2 or 3 approaches or theories under this contingency approach or contingency theories. So basically, this contingency approach or contingency theory is based on 4 different approaches. Number 1, the appropriate leadership style depends on the requirement of the situation. The kind of style a leader should exert, it depends on environment or situation. Some situation can demand from you that you should be very kind of participative, friendly with your followers. But in the other situation, when the followers are different, the different type of leadership style might be required. At one place, you might be teaching as a leader to your followers, because they might be very willing worker with you, but they might not be knowing the technique. So here, your style will be different. Another place, they might be knowing how to do the job, but they might not be willing. So you need to sell it. You need to persuade to them. So see, each according to situation, You need to change your style. Clear? So first assumption was that the kind of leadership style any leader can exert will depend on the requirement of the situation. Number two, leadership can be learned. Of course, this was also the assumption under the behavior approach, that this is not something you came with the genetic makeup. This is the kind of thing you can learn. And with the time, with the training, with the learning, you can learn those traits, those skills, those attitude which are required for you to be a leader. The third was, successful leadership involves understanding situational contingency basically. A person who should understand what is the requirement of the situation. And the fourth one, the match between the leader style, personality, our behavior, and the situation leads to effectiveness. That is also very important. So basically, this contingency approach is based on, our contingency theory is based on four assumptions. Number one, that leadership style will depend on the type of situation. Number two, leadership is, our leaders' traits are, you can easily learn them. Of course, it is not that easy, if otherwise everybody should be leader. But they can be learned. Number three, successful leader involves understanding of situational contingencies. Number four, the match between the leader style, the situation, and of course the followers is very important for the effectiveness of the leadership. So as I said earlier, under the leadership strategies, under the leadership approach, under the leadership theory, there were three different type of studies which was carried out initially. We call it, number one, Felder LPC model. There is another one we call it path goal model. And there is a third one we call it situational leadership theory model or situational leadership theory. And each has specific characteristics. I can go one by one and explain to you. But let me give you a few basic points. That for the first LPC model, the leadership behavior assessment, situational favorability, and behavior situation match was the important focus. While for the path goal model, the subordinate characteristics, the task structure, the leadership behavior, the performance satisfaction was the basic thing which was the focus of this approach. And the situational leadership approach or situational theory, the leadership readiness, delegating, participating, selling, and telling behavior or style of the leadership. Let's go with one by one. Number one, the contingency theory, which was learned by Felder and his colleague in 1974, they tried basically to match the leaders to appropriate situation. And according to this theory, the effectiveness of leadership is contingent on matching the leader style to the right setting of the, setting of what? The situation or the organization basically. And this leadership of theory or approach is indicating that the leader's effectiveness depends on how well the leader's style is fitting with the situation. The Felder contingency model holds that leader effectiveness is determined by the leadership style and situational variables. They use this LPC kind of abbreviation that stands for least preferred co-worker scale. They kind of define a scale to see the effectiveness of leaders. So they basically identify two different styles, as I said earlier. The task-motivated leader's style, a leadership style. And the second one was the relationship-motivated leaders. I explained this, that the task-motivated leaders are those which were mainly concerned with the goal, with the goal of the organization, with the goal of the group, with the goal of the team. While the relationship-motivated leaders, they were more concerned with the developing a close interpersonal relationship with the workers. And then they decided, they defined kind of a scale, they call it, to understand this under this strategy, under this approach, the style of the leaders. And the scale was, they call it LPC scale. That was basically least preferred core worker scale, they call it. And it started with the low and it reached to high. And based on this LPC scale, they decided if it was, the style was more toward the relationship side, so they gave it a high LPC style of leader. So the leader which was more concerned about the co-worker, which were more concerned about the developing the relation, interpersonal relationship with the colleagues or followers, and according to this theory, according to this approach, they were at the high scale of LPC, while the leader which were more concerned about the goal only, and it was at the low scale of least preferred co-workers scales or LPC scale. So this was the first approach, first theory according to contingence or contingency approach or theory, right? Just a few more lecture maybe and we'll be done with these approaches and theories. You know, this is theoretical part and bit sometime boring, okay? So ladies and gentlemen, next was situational leadership theory, a situational leadership approach. The Hersey and his colleagues, they kind of developed this approach. They call it situational leadership approach or situational leadership theory. It states that effective leader behavior depends on situational contingent or readiness and the appropriate behavior readiness match. What does it mean? That it depends the kind of situation you are dealing and kind of attitude you have, and then based on their matches, they design or they develop this, they call it situation theory. Let me explain to you a situation where we can have four different type of styles of leadership. Let's see if your followers are unwilling and same time they're unable to deliver what a leader will do. Now, and under this situation or under this specific environment, what kind of behavior or style a leader should have? Basically, a leader needs to give clear and specific direction now here, because the followers are neither they are willing to do something and nor they have the ability, right? So here you need to basically sell, they call it in the terminology, in the different texts they use it, selling style of the leaders. So now the situation is that you have the followers which are unable to do something. Same time, their excitement, their willingness is very low level. Now what you have to do? You have to persuade now. You have to tell them. You have to give them very clear direction and specific also, so that they should be able to deliver something. Let's talk about another situation. When you have the followers, of course they are unable to deliver something. They are lacking the skill sets, but now they are willing to do something. They have the motivation. They have the zeal basically to do something. Now here the leader needs to display high task orientation and high relationship orientation. So basically you will be telling them how to do it. You will be training them because they are already willing to do it. You need to give them the training. So here you are as a leader, the style will be a telling leadership style. Let's talk about the third situation where you have the followers which are able, which are technically good, but they are unwilling. What is needed here? So here leader needs to use supportive and participative management style. Here leader need to involve them. How can you create the willingness in the which are unwilling worker, unwilling followers? So ladies and gentlemen, as I said, the third approach, the third situation is under this situation theory, that if you have a situation where the workers, where the followers They are able, they are technically good, they can deliver, but they are not willing to do. So you need to build their, you need to back up them. You need to build their morale. You need to create in them the ownership. So here, the leader need to have a style of participating management style, where the leader need to kind of provide an environment, ask them to come in the decision making, let them participate in the thing, and let them own these things. So naturally, the style of the leader which is required under this particular situation will be more toward participative style. The fourth situation indicated in this slide is basically where you have both able and willing workers. Are the followers are, of course, they can deliver. In the same time, they are excited, they want to do it, and they are owning it. So what is needed? So leader need to have a lenient kind of approach, and that will be more as delegating type of leadership style. Get the point? So under this approach, with these four examples, I think it will be, you can understand it better. Let me quickly go through them again. So number one situation is, when you have the followers, when you have the co-worker, other workers in your group, in your organization, which are neither willing to do anything, nor they have the ability or capability. So here you need to have a style of persuasive leader. You need to sell it. How you can sell it? You first need to explain to them what this is, what kind of task you are expecting from him or her or from them, and why it is benefit. You not only need to create the awareness, train them, rather also create excitement in them. So you need to, what you need to do, basically you have to identify specific clear direction for each of your followers so that they should deliver. So second situation is where you have the willingness, but they are not able to do something. Here you need to tell them how to do it. You need to provide them the orientation how to do it, because they are willing to do it. The third situation I explained to you is when you have the ability in your followers, but they are not willing. So now the point will be, the kind of characteristics in the leader or the style of leader should be participating leader. Because once you will bring your followers on board in the decision making, in the discussion, so naturally they have the ability, they can do it, but you need to bring their kind of excitement in the group so that they should own it and they should start delivering. So here, the leadership style will be required as the participating leadership style. The fourth one was that where you have both the abilities and the willingness available in your followers. So then you need to have a lenient type of style where you can have the, they call it delegating style of the leadership. Samajh aa gayi? So basically, is situation theory ke andar, aapko bataya, ki ye situation ke hisab se aapko leader ki un abilities ko match karana hai. और फिर उस सिचुएशन के मुताबिक एक स्पेसिफिक स्टाइल के हिसाब से लीडर को चलना है, जिसकी वजह से वो अपने गोल्स को अचीव कर सकेंगे. सो दैट वाज़ द सेकंड कंटीजेंस अप्रोच, सेकंड कंटीजेंसी थ्योरी व्हिच वाज़ एक्सप्लेन टू यू राइट नाउ. सो द थर्ड अप्रोच, थर्ड थ्योरी, थर्ड मॉडल अंडर दिस कंटीजेंसी अप्रोच और कंटीजेंसी थ्योरी इज द पाथ गोल मॉडल. दिस इज वेल नोन मॉडल बिकॉज of its emphasis on how a leader influences subordinates. Perception of work goals and personal goals, and the link of paths found between these two set of goals. So this has made this path goal theory very interesting and effective, because it states that it is the leader's job to assist the followers in attaining their goals and to provide them the necessary direction and support. This path goal approach model or theory mainly emphasizes that it is the responsibility of the leader to set the goal, to decide or teach the people the roadmap, how to approach them, how to reach it. So this theory is basically assuming that leader's job is to assist the followers in attaining the goals. Not only this, but to provide the necessary support, training, direction, whatever is required to the followers for the attainment of goals. And a leader motivational behavior also makes the employee need their satisfaction contingent on effective performance and provide the coaching, guidance, support, reward that are necessary for the effective performance. So ladies and gentlemen, this path, goal, model or theory is mainly emphasizing that this is the job or responsibility of the leader to create the situation where followers can perform. They need to make their followers motivated so that they should have positive performance. They need to provide coaching, training, guidance, support, and of course the reward that are necessary for effective performance. This theory also assumes that leader's style is flexible and can be changed to adapt the situation in hand or whatever situation he or she is facing. So under this approach, this model, they also identify four different type of behavior or the style. Number one, the directive leader. Let's imply know what is expected from them. Schedule work to be done and give specific guidance as to how to accomplish those tasks. So under this approach of path goal model or approach or leadership theory, they identify four different type of leadership behaviors. First is, as I said, the directive leadership behavior, a directive leadership style. Under this, it is assumed that the leader will kind of direct that what is expected from the followers. He is going to arrange the facilities, but same time, give a clear schedule and road map that this is need to be done. So this type of approach or behavior is known as directive leadership behavior or directive leaders. You might have understood or identified that we're talking same type of things. But the way they started, they explained it, the way they kind of related is a bit different. The second behavior, supportive leadership. This type of leader show more concern about the followers. They show more concern about their colleagues. And they are very friendly with their colleagues and followers. So they are always providing the support. So this type of approach or behavior or model or style is known as supportive leader model. So supportive leader behavior, supportive leader style, not the model basically. It is style, behavior, or approach. The third one is participative leaders. Same thing which we used in the previous one, situational, right? The participative leader basically, what he or she is doing, they consult with the employees and ask them to give the suggestion before making any decisions. So it is more toward participative management. So if a leader has this type of style or behavior, we call it participative leader. The fourth one is achievement-oriented leader. The similar type of, we say, the task-oriented leader in the last style and last theory basically. The achievement-oriented leader sets challenging goals. They expect that an employee will perform at their highest level. So if a leader is such type of leader, we call that leader has a achievement-oriented style, leadership style. So under the path goal leadership model, we have four style of leaders or four type of behaviors of the leaders. Number one, directive leaders, as the name indicates. Number two, supportive leader. Number three, participative leader. Number four, achievement-oriented leader. And the model indicates that the leader behavior is depending on the type of followers and the type of environment or situation. The contingency of employees or the followers and contingency of the situation is affecting the behavior of the leader. What is required, what is demanded, and the type of leader behavior, like if they have the directive, supportive, participative, achievement oriented, right? And the effectiveness of those things will depend on the type of followers they have and the type of environment in which they are performing. And they can motivate the employees, they can satisfy the employees, and leader can be accepted or not accepted. So this BATH goal model of leadership basically is putting more emphasis on the responsibility on the leader. That they need to set the path, they need to prepare the roadmap, and if required, train the followers, facilitate the followers, and they can opt different type of behavior by maybe by directing them. They can do it by providing them support, extra support, showing more concern, or by participating approach. The last one was the achievement oriented. So this was the path goal approach we covered under the contingency theories. So ये सारी जो theories थी ये सारी क्या indicate कर रही कि किस तरह देखा जाए, क्या indicators हैं, क्या relationship है follower situation और leader का for the effectiveness or performance of any organization or goal achievements. अब मुख्तलिफ किस्म की literature के अंदर आपको यही चीजें कुछ different styles से wording से भी मिलेंगी. किसी ने उसको participative कहा होगा, किसी ने उसको कुछ और लफ्ज इस्तेमाल किया होगा. जैसे मैंने आपसे कहा कि शुरू में इनिशियली देयर वर ओनली टू थ्योरीज, स्टेट थ्योरी एंड बिहेवियर थ्योरीज. बाद में कंटिजेंसी स्टडीज को ऐड कर दी गई और कंटिजेंसी अप्रोच को ले लिया गया. अब इस अप्रोच को और थ्योरीज को भी साइमल्टेनियसली यूज किया गया मुख्तलिफ जगहों पर. थ्योरीज को मोर स्पेसिफिक देखते हुए उसको जो है कि ब्रॉडर स्पेक्ट्रम में देखा गया और अप्रोचेस को जरा उसको विद इन वन थ्योरी डिफरेंट अप्रोचेस को भी डिस्कस किया गया. जैसा कंटिजेंसी के अंदर आप देखें सिचुएशनल था, एलपीसी स्केल के ऊपर एक अप्रोच हमने देखी, और ये जो पाथ गोल अप्रोच देखी. और मुख्तलिफ रिसर्चर ने, मुख्तलिफ एजुकेशनर्स ने जो किताबें लिखी, लिटरेचर लिखा, उसके अंदर और डिफरेंट अप्रोचेस को भी डिस्कस किया. लाइक इन वन केस ही हैज इंडिकेटेड 5-6 अप्रोचेस, वही ट्रेड अप्रोच, बिहेवियर अप्रोच, एंड देन दे स्टार्टेड अनदर वन, पावर एंड इन्फ्लुएंस अप्रोच, और फिर सिचुएशनल अप्रोच तो हमने डिस्कस कर ली, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल अप्रोच, क्रिस्मेटिक अप्रोच, क्रिज्मा के हिसाब से. तो ये सारी अप्रोचेस based on those studies, those research people conducted, and the focusing again on the leaders and leadership process. अभी एक और लेक्चर हम इस पे और मैं आपके साथ शेयर करूंगा, अगला लेक्चर भी, बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू गिव मोर फोकस ऑन दिस क्रिज्मा थिंग. और ये लफ्ज भी बड़ा बज वर्ड है हमारी सोसाइटी के अंदर हर तरफ कि बड़ा क्रिज्मेटिक लीडर था वो, उनके अंदर बड़ा क्रिज्मा था. व्हाट इज दिस क्रिज्मेटिक थिंग, व्हाट इज क्रिज्मा, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल और इस तरह के जो बाकी लीडरशिप अप्रोचेस हैं उसको भी मैं आपके साथ शेयर करूंगा, लेकिन वो मैं अगले लेक्चर के लिए रखता हूं ताकि थोड़ा सा रिलैक्स होके आप भी मैं भी उसको आपके साथ शेयर करें. अभी यहां कंटिन्यू करते हैं, लेट्स सी कि थोड़ा सा मैं आपको इसी इन्हीं थ्योरीज के हिसाब से थोड़ा सा हिस्ट्री की तरफ लेके चलता हूं कि हाउ दिस वॉज शिफ्टेड, किस तरह ट्रेड थ्योरी शिफ्ट हुई सिचुएशन थ्योरी के अंदर, कहां से सिचुएशनल थ्योरी से कंटिजेंसी थ्योरीज पे आप आए, और फिर अब आजकल के दौर में हम क्या सोच रहे हैं, किस अप्रोच को हम ज्यादा एम्फेसाइज देना चाहते हैं, किस अप्रोच को हम ज्यादा मुनासिब समझते हैं, हर कोई अपने अपने लिहाज से उसको एक्सप्लेन करने की कोशिश करता है। सही है? तो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट लीडरशिप थ्योरी का जो ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री बैकग्राउंड है। ए थ्रेड अप्रोच, जैसे मैंने आपसे कहा कि ये शुरू की 50 साल जो 19th सेंचुरी के थे, फ्रॉम 1900 टू 1950s का ये फोकस रहा, दैट लीडर्स आर बॉर्न नॉट मेड। दैट वॉज द बेसिक अजम्पशन बेस्ड ऑन विच दिस थ्योरी वॉज डिवेल्प एंड कंटिन्यूड फॉर 50 ईयर्स। द फोकस ऑफ द अर्ली लीडरशिप रिसर्च वॉज टू फाइंड द पर्सनल ट्रेड बेसिकली दैट डिस्टिंग्विश लीडर फ्रॉम द फॉलोअर्स। सो दिस वॉज द मेन फोकस, एज आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू कपल ऑफ टाइम। द सर्च वॉज नॉट सक्सेसफुल, बहुत सारी इसमें स्टडीज हुई, हंड्रेड ऑफ स्टडीज वर कैरिड आउट, और लेकिन कंक्लूजन क्या हुआ, देर वॉज नो सच सेट ऑफ पर्सनल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट बाई देम सेल्फ डिस्टिंग्विश लीडर फ्रॉम द फॉलोअर्स। ये जितनी स्टडीज हुई इसका मेन एम्फेसाइज, मेन फोकस ये था कि हम किसी तरह उन पर्सनल जो पर्सनल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक पर्सनैलिटी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स होते हैं टू बी स्पेसिफिक, उनको आइडेंटिफाई किया जाए ताकि हम लीडर्स को फॉलोअर्स से सेपरेट कर सकें, ताकि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आसानी से राइट टाइप ऑफ लीडर को सिलेक्ट करके ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का लीडर बना दें, उस ग्रुप का लीडर बना दें, उस टीम का लीडर बना दें जो उसको विनिंग टीम, सक्सेसफुल ग्रुप और प्रॉस्पर और सक्सेसफुल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बना सके। लेकिन यह कामयाबी नहीं हुई। यस, ए फ्यू ट्रेड्स सच एज इंटेलिजेंस, रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस, इंटेग्रिटी और जो ट्रस्ट वाली चीजें होती हैं, ये जरूर आइडेंटिफाई हो गई इस सारे प्रोसेस के दौरान, इस सारे जो सर्च थी या रिसर्च थी, जो सारी जो स्टडीज थी उसके बेस पे ये आइडेंटिफाई होंगी। लेकिन ये इतनी ज्यादा नहीं थी कि जो जिस मकसद के लिए सारा स्टडी किया गया, ठीक है ना। लेटेस्ट स्टडीज ऑफ लीडरशिप कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स लेड टू द कंक्लूजन दैट देयर वर अ फ्यू जनरल ट्रेट्स दैट वर एसोसिएटेड विद द इफेक्टिव लीडरशिप। वो क्या थे? वही जो मैंने आपसे कहा, सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस, स्ट्रेस टॉलरेंस, इमोशनल मैच्योरिटी, इंटेग्रिटी। बट अगेन, नो ट्रेड्स आर सेट ऑफ ट्रेड्स बाय इटसेल्फ गारंटीड कि जिसके अंदर ये चीजें होंगी वो सक्सेसफुल लीडर होगा। बात समझ आई? कि ये सारी चीजें तो आइडेंटिफाई होगी उस 50 साल की जो स्टडीज थी, रिसर्च थी, कि यस यू कैन ऑब्वियसली सी कि जो अच्छे लीडर हैं उनके अंदर ये चीजें बड़ी जबरदस्त होती हैं। लेकिन क्या जिनके अंदर ये सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस होगा वो अच्छे लीडर हो सकते हैं? क्या जिनके अंदर इंटेग्रिटी है वो अच्छे लीडर हो सकते हैं? दैट वॉज ए बिग क्वेश्चन जिसने उनको सेटिस्फाई नहीं किया, उनको आंसर नहीं दिया। बोथ द सिचुएशन एंड स्किल्स आल्सो, उन्होंने क्या उनको क्या समझ आई बाद में कि ना सिर्फ ये ट्रेड्स बल्कि सिचुएशन और स्किल सेट और जो उसके फॉलोअर्स हैं ये सारे बड़े इंपॉर्टेंट हैं उसके लीडरशिप प्रोसेस को समझने के लिए। सही है? फिर उसी बेस पे सिचुएशन लीडरशिप स्टडीज को देखा गया कि यस लीडर्स आर नॉट बर्न, दे कैन बी मेड। उस बेस पे एक थोड़े कर्से के लिए 50s में स्टार्ट हुआ और चंद सालों तक इस पे काफी स्टडी हुई, और फिर सोशियोलॉजिस्ट जो थे उन्होंने ट्राई टू डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट दैट सिचुएशन डिटरमिन लीडरशिप, बट दे टू वर अनसक्सेसफुल टू रिलेट टू मैच स्पेसिफिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक विथ स्पेसिफिक सिचुएशन। इसके बाद क्या हुआ? फिर लाइट जिस तरह वो ट्रेड अप्रोच थी, ट्रेडिशनल अप्रोच भी इतनी सक्सेसफुल ना हुई। सो फिर बाद में लोगों ने एहसास हुआ कि नहीं, यहां पे तो तीन इनपुट्स हैं, तीन किस्म के इंडिकेट एलिमेंट्स हैं जिनको इग्नोर नहीं किया जा सकता, और तीनों को साइमल्टेनियसली स्टडी करना पड़ेगा। और वो तीनों क्या थे? लीडर, फॉलोअर्स एंड सिचुएशन। एंड इन तीनों का आपस में इंटीग्रेट करना प्रॉपर सिचुएशन के हिसाब से इसको समझने के लिए फिर कॉन्टिजेंसी अप्रोचेस के जरिए इस सारे प्रोसेस को समझने की कोशिश की गई। सिचुएशन के अंदर एक पर्टिकुलर स्टाइल के साथ स्पेसिफिक फॉलोअर के साथ किस तरह का बिहेवियर होना चाहिए, किस तरह का एटीट्यूड होना चाहिए और किस तरह के स्टाइल होना चाहिए जो किसी एक को सक्सेसफुल और नॉन सक्सेसफुल अनसक्सेसफुल लीडर बना सकते हैं, इफेक्टिव लीडर और अनइफेक्टिव लीडर बना सकते हैं। इस कंटीजेंसी अप्रोच ने यह तो बता दिया आपको कि यहां ये तीन इनपुट्स हैं, तीन इंडिकेटर्स हैं, तीं फैक्टर्स हैं जो इफेक्ट करते हैं लीडरशिप प्रोसेस को, बट दे आर नॉट सक्सेसफुल टू आइडेंटिफाई ए सॉल्यूशन। हां, एक सॉल्यूशन मिला कि भाई स्पेसिफिक टाइप की एनवायरमेंट के अंदर इस तरह का बिहेवियर होना चाहिए और यह बिहेवियर सीखा जा सकता है, ये लर्न किया जा सकता है। स्पेसिफिक एनवायरमेंट के अंदर ये स्किल सेट चाहिए, ये ट्रेन की जा सकती है, सिखाई जा सकती है। लेकिन ऐसा नहीं हुआ कि आपने एक फिक्स मॉडल दरियाफ्त कर लिया कि ये मॉडल, ये स्टाइल, ये हर जगह कामयाब हो गया। नहीं, क्योंकि बाकी जो फैक्टर्स हैं वो भी अपना पार्ट प्ले कर रहे हैं, लाइक टाइप ऑफ फॉलोअर्स एंड टाइप ऑफ सिचुएशन। तो ये स्टडी जो कंटेम्पररी अप्रोच ऑफ लीडरशिप जो थी, दैट दे बेसिकली एक्नॉलेज दैट इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ मैचिंग दीज ट्रेट्स एंड लीडरशिप बिहेवियर टू सिचुएशन एंड द फॉलोअर्स जो उसके एटीट्यूड बिहेवियर है, दैट कैन हेल्प अस टू मैक्सिमाइज द इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ द लीडरशिप। अगर हम किसी तरह इनको मैच कर लें तो हम इसको मोर इफेक्टिव बना सकते हैं। और तारीख की अगर उस हम उसको देखें तो 1920 तक के जो टाइम है उसको हम ट्रेड थ्योरी का नाम दे सकते हैं कि ज्यादा फोकस इस पे था। 1920 से लेकर 40 और 50 की दिहाई से आगे तक फिर इट वॉज मोर टूवर्ड ओहायो स्टेट, मिशिगन और वो जो सारी स्टडीज हुई उसके बेस पे बिहेवियर अप्रोच की तरफ चला गया। और उसके बाद एंड ऑफ लास्ट सेंचुरी जो है इट वॉज मेनली फोकसिंग ऑन दी कंटीजेंस थ्योरी। उसके बेस पे आज हम क्या देख रहे हैं, नाउ देर आर फ्यू न्यू एनवायरमेंट, देर इज न्यू फोर्सिंग अफेक्टिंग द लीडरशिप थिंग। तो आज अब एक और नई जस्तजू के अंदर लोग जो हैं, यस दिस कंटीजेंस थ्योरी स्टिल प्रिवेल, वो जो फैक्टर्स हैं, वो चीजें हैं, वो इंपॉर्टेंट आइडेंटिफाई हो गई, लेकिन लोग एक नई तलाश के अंदर शुरू हो चुके हैं कि जो आजकल नेटवर्क लीडर्स हैं, आजकल जो नेटवर्किंग का कॉन्सेप्ट आ रहा है, आजकल जो इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी का कॉन्सेप्ट आ रहा है और जो फिर वर्चुअल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का कॉन्सेप्ट आ रहा है, तो इसके अंदर अब कौन सा स्टाइल लीडरशिप, अब कौन सी अप्रोच लेनी चाहिए, तो वो जो लर्निंग प्रोसेस है इट कंटिन्यू। तो जो आज से सैकड़ों साल पहले लोगों ने इनपुट डाला था, आज भी हम उसको पढ़ के आगे लेके चल रहे हैं और आगे आने आने वाले सैकड़ों सालों में लोग जो आप और मैं और बाकी लोग आज कंट्रीब्यूट कर देंगे उसको लेके आगे चलेंगे। सो देयर इज नो एंड, इट इज अ कंटिन्यू प्रोसेस। वी नीड टू मूव, वी नीड टू लर्न, वी नीड टू एड मोर इन दिस ओशन ऑफ द नॉलेज सो दैट वी शुड ऑल्सो बी द पार्ट ऑफ हिस्ट्री। आई स्टॉप इट हियर, आई होप वी आर पिकिंग अप। टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ, अल्लाह हाफिज, अस्सलाम वालेकुम।